Love it. I love it. The colors are amazing. The colors are like the Miami Heat uniforms right now.
All right, so Ben Schwartz is
here.
Hi,
Brooke Morrison. How
are
you?
Hello. Hello. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thanks.
Good. So I saw Sonic on Monday.
Did you?
Yeah, I just saw it.
Oh, what'd you think?
I liked it a lot, and I'm really happy that they redid the character,
good,
like
good,
your character.
Good, good.
Yeah. How
great.
Do you feel about the finished product, though?
I love the way he looks now.
Yeah.
I think he looks exactly how I thought he was in my head when I was voicing him.
Okay. So did you see him before you
when
started
we're voicing
it?
It's kind of like pre-viz. It's like old, like animation stuff. So I never got to really,
okay.
I very rarely worked with what he looked like until
right.
the very, very end when you're doing ADR. So
okay.
I was kind of just picturing in my head what he would look like.
Okay. So when you finally saw him, it was the new Sonic?
Yes.
Okay.
This new Sonic is a beauty.
Have you seen the full, you've seen the full movie, right?
I have. Yeah.
How do you like the movie as a whole? With everybody together.
I love it. I think Jim Carrey is amazing. I think James and Tika are amazing. I think it's funny. It has these big action sequences. And right after our movie, we saw it with a group of kids. It was like this big screening with kids and adults.
Yeah.
And the kids were running up and down the aisles and they're saying, gotta go fast. And they're running everywhere. And it was so cute.
Yeah.
I've left so many voice memos for my friends, for their kids.
Oh, that's amazing.
It's been so, I feel really lucky.
Yeah. No, and you've done a lot of different stuff, actually, when it comes to voiceover work. And
Brooke, you're not even looking down. You just know things.
No,
a lot of people look at notes and such. I know
well,
you have five
have
screens
notes.
In front of you.
I do have notes in front of me, so you can't, it's there. It's there. But at the same time, like, I find you incredibly interesting. I mean, you've been doing this forever, and I love voiceover work in general, and you've done a lot of cartoons, and you do, like, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and DuckTales.
I play Leonardo in Turtles. I play Dewey Duck on DuckTales.
Yeah.
And then a bunch of other fun stuff, like I'm on BoJack a little bit, and I just
crazy.
Love the whole medium. I grew up on like the Disney Afternoon and stuff.
Of course.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. And
so
that's what my next question was basically what other, I mean, you've already done so much, but like what would you love to do next as far as like cartoons, like classic video games go or anything like that?
That's a great question. I've never done an actual video game. I might want to do like a lead character in a video game. That might be fun. I don't know. It kind of, anytime I do an animated thing, it's got to be like, if the script is really funny or like, I'd be like, oh, this is fun or it's different.
Yeah.
Or it's a character that I was like, oh, I got to be in DuckTales. Like
right.
that literally came and I auditioned for that. I wasn't given anything. Same with everything I like kind of worked hard for. The way I got Sonic is I did a test so they could sell it to different studios. So, so we did a test so we could sell it to Paramount. And then they just loved the test so much they kept me around. Because surely there are way more famous people than I that would love to be this role. But I just lucked out that they really liked the way I did it.
Okay, was it true that Tom Hanks was going to be the voice?
I said that once in interviews, just because I improv a lot. So each time I'd make up a different celebrity. So once it was Daniel Day-Lewis.
Okay.
And so I think I said, you know, Tom Hanks passed. And then on the internet, they're like, Tom Hanks. I was like, oh, I don't.
That is modern day internet for you.
You can't say
anything. And it's like a whole situation. I was going to say, like, how did it feel to step into those shoes? But they were your shoes to begin with. So
they
it didn't
were my
even.
But I mean, at the beginning, you know, like there's great people who did it for the video games and for the cartoons. Like Jaleel White did it. Urkel was one of the, not to call him Urkel, but Jaleel White did it. a gentleman named Ryan Drummond. There's a gentleman named Jason, a gentleman named Roger Craig Smith. And all these people had done it before me. And then when it came to this, I was like, oh, I want to keep the legacy going because the fans are like, they're passionate. They love this character. So
they do.
I was like, if I can make the fans excited at what I'm doing, if they get kind of what I'm trying to do, making them in this energetic kid, it would be a huge deal. And they really have been so supportive.
Yeah. So you said you auditioned for this. And this is something that I'm interested in as well with like voiceover work, you know, since I do radio and stuff like that. For
do you
anybody,
do voiceover as well?
No. And that's basically what, like, I would love to get into it, but it's kind of like this
right
really closed
pretend
off work.
You are, okay. This is what I want.
Okay.
Tell me.
Right.
And you got to pick a new voice. You can't do your own.
Oh.
Which is kind of hard because I do variations of my own voice.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's say we're in a cartoon and in the cartoon, it's me. I'm going to play like a big mushroom. I'm a big old mushroom.
Oh, okay.
And you come in and you're like a lily. Okay.
Oh.
You come in as a lily.
Okay.
Okay. And this is the audition. Slate your name at the top, please.
Brooke Morrison.
Okay. Ready? Are you all set? Do you need a minute or you're fine?
What am I saying?
Well, I'm going to just talk to you and you're going to respond.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
okay?
I'm ready.
Okay,
I'm ready.
Ready? Here we go. Yeah. Hey, what's going on, Lily?
Oh, I'm doing fine today.
Okay. So I'm going to stop you there. So it's your voice just very, very like, very like a wispy lil. I love it. Okay,
yes.
All right, good.
Yes, yes.
You got the role.
Oh, I did not.
It's so easy. You did it. You nailed it.
I did not. And that's what I'm scared of is like, what if I do go in there and I audition for something and all of a sudden they're like, your voice is crap. And then like the next day I get on the radio and I'm like, well, I can't do this because my voice is crap.
No,
you know what
voice,
I mean?
You're on the radio all day. You know
I
your
know.
Voice works well on the radio.
Hopefully.
Can you listen to yourself or is it too much?
No, I can't listen to myself unless I like do like a... like an air check or something like that, and then listen like to the whole show later on. But like, I can't really, so yeah, it's like a thing. Yourself,
whenever I hear myself, like back in the day, especially, Sonic the Hedgehog just
Sonic
came in the
just
room.
Walked in. Hello, Sonic.
Sonic the Hedgehog is here, everybody.
Hi. Oh my God, your fur is beautiful, by the way.
Oh, he's so happy. I can translate for Sonic. Yeah, he's very happy.
Oh, he's happy right now?
Yeah, he's super happy right
Sonic,
now.
Sonic, what'd you eat for breakfast?
This is basically what, for the audio audience, there's an actual Sonic the Hedgehog that just came in and just rocking it.
Looks amazing.
But I will say, for voiceover stuff, I've been told no a billion times.
Yeah.
And it's because it doesn't even mean that you're bad. It just means that for this particular thing, you're not right. Which works for a lot of jobs. Like, you're not bad at that. You're just not the correct role.
Right. So what is the first step to even getting into voiceover? Because you've been doing acting, I mean, for like ever.
Yeah.
So like, I'm guessing you were kind of in that circle. But for somebody who like just started out and they live in the middle of nowhere, like what is the first step?
So for Sonic, it was, I did a test. They just chose me to be the person to do their test for them to try to sell it.
Right.
But for DuckTales or Turtles, the way that I started is before I had anything, I did commercials. And then I asked if I can do voiceover commercials. That's how I started. And it's like nothing. Like things on the radio and just regional districts that I did, and rarely ever got a job. Finally got a job or two, slowly got a little bit. So now I have a little bit of stuff that I can show people. This is my voiceover reel.
Right.
And then I would audition for TV shows, like a Disney XD show. I got this thing called Randy Cunningham. And the way that that gentleman, Aaron, found out about me is he came to one of my improv shows.
Oh, yeah.
And he heard. So just performing and getting yourself out there. But now I feel like you have a world where you can create your own content. I mean, look, you guys don't know, but like Brooke is operating this entire show. You go into different radio booths and there's an engineer and there's all these people, but Brooke is behind there doing the knobs and also everything. So
Stop it right now.
But exactly, like that's what I think you have to do almost to get seen. Like you have to make your own videos and post them on Twitter, YouTube, TikTok, whatever.
Right.
You have to do all that. So if you want to do those things, you just kind of put yourself to do it. So if I was starting off now, and I want to be a VO artist, I would find a way to make my voice go out and find an animator or something, just put it to, or even pick up a dog and pretend I'm the dog's face or something like that. Yeah.
Okay, I need to get a dog then. That's what I need to do next.
Well, this is basically just adopt dogs, basically what this whole interview is about.
Exactly. I used to walk dogs in LA, so I feel like that's like easy to get a hold of dogs.
You know, you're a dog person.
So, yeah, so So good. But last question I have for you is basically towards the end of the movie, and I feel like you would know more than I would about any of this, but Dr. Robotnik kind of like foreshadows maybe a sequel? Is there something? Well,
I will
like
say
out there
that I would love to do another movie. I would love to.
Good.
And Jim, the biggest thing is, does Jim Carrey want to do another movie? And he has been very vocal in saying yes.
Yeah.
He loves to, because he's like, there's so much more we could do with Robotnik.
Right.
But it's so crazy. Much as this kind of movie has always been in the hands of the audience, like now it's just how many people go see this movie. If enough people see it, we get to make more.
Right.
But it's totally out of our hands, outside of I get to talk about it with people like you and stuff like that. But I hope people dig it, man, because I would love to make more of these, because there's so many different things we could do. And if you play these games, there's a bunch of different characters we could play with. So I hope that people like it, because then we can make more.
People will like it.
You did
it's adorable.
This is like Field of Dreams. People will like it.
people
will come.
Yeah, because if you build it, they will come. It's already been built. They redid the character and there's so much hype around it. I just think that's the main thing right now, is people have been waiting on this for months and months and months.
I think so. And then some people have been waiting on it for like since 1991.
Yes.
So it's like, I'm psyched.
Exactly.
I really like how the movie came out, so I'm psyched.
Good, good. Okay, well, Ben Schwartz, thank you so
much. Thank you, Brooke. I appreciate
it. For stopping by, and now we got to go say hi to Sonic.
Yeah.
Yes.